Hey everybody, welcome back for another Ever Crisis video. What's going on? It's your boy Time. Got some updates today that they were given out for the notice for actually just 2 days out instead of Thursday. It's coming out on Tuesday. We got some crazy stuff. We got events. We got some changes to the draw tickets, which I personally am extremely excited about. And then also we have new co-op battles coming in. So we'll actually start off with the bottom thing, co-op battles. If you're a new player to the game, this is great, perfect. This is where you're going to want to do all your grinding for like Ifrit memories and Ramu memories, as well as get the equipment. If you don't have that stuff yet, again, this is where you're going to want to do it. Do it in co-op. You have the best drop chances. You're going to get more rewards, and it's a lot easier to do them. So that's going to be coming on Tuesday. So pretty cool thing to notice. You know, it's a great place to also get co-op medals. So that's going to happen. It's going to last for a little over a week, it looks like, until the 8th. So it's going to go from Tuesday to the following Thursday, it looks like. So that's going to be really cool. So Ifrit and Ramu, surprised that Shiva is not coming back. Interesting choice on that one. So that's a really cool thing that's going to happen. They're going to be adding additional draw tickets here, which is awesome. Or not draw tickets, I'm sorry, but they're going to add the weapons into the draw tickets. So we're going to get basically all the Christmas, the rest of the Christmas weapons, and then also the New Year's weapons thrown in, except for Yuffie's banner. So we're going to have Micro Laser. We're going to have Snowflake. Micro Laser is the one for Barret. Snowflake is going to be the weapon for Aerith. Twinkling Star, that is going to be the weapon for Zach. We got Bramble Spine, which is going to be the weapon for Matt. Sky Splitter, which is the Cloud Fire weapon, and Radiant Edge, which is the Sephiroth Fire weapon. So I'm really excited for these personally. I have been holding off on using any of my draw tickets, both regular 4-star and guaranteed 5-star, until these two specifically were going to be thrown in, because I pulled on the banner all the way to page 2. I didn't pull a single of Sephiroth's weapon, and then I also didn't get a single of... I got 3 of Cloud's weapons. So I hardly got, like, for going 2 pages, I didn't get crap. It was the worst pull I ever done. I was super salty. If you saw that pull, those pulls in one of my other videos, you'll see how I was not happy, man. So I've been saving for these. Hopefully I can pull those, because those are the ones I really specifically want out of any of these. Obviously, it's a really low chance, but I got tons of tickets nonetheless on my main account. This is my alternate account here, my free-to-play one that I've been kind of working on to get some cool new content for you guys when we run into some of these events that are going to be coming up, how to tackle them as a weaker player. So that's going to be a cool thing. And then the last thing that's coming up, which is the big one, it's the next event. Essentially, it's the Valentine's Day event, which is starting on the 30th. So just technically tomorrow, I guess, at this point. But really, for me, it's like 2 days, because it's about a little past midnight. But it's called the Secret Sweetheart. It's going to be just like the Christmas event, where we're gonna have the cards. There's gonna be this different stages and things like that. So it's a pretty simple event. It's not that bad, and I actually can give you guys a little bit of a heads up if you didn't get to experience a Christmas event for any reason. The way this event works is you'll essentially have an idle items, where over time it's just going to build up, and you can kind of see the meter here. It's going to build up over time, and you're just going to fill that up and then just grab items. Now, previously, when I first did it the first time, my thinking was, oh hey, I'll just, you know, I'll gather it when it hits max, because I thought maybe the level gave you better drops, but the level doesn't. It doesn't give you any better drops. It just increases the amount of items you can get, and it gathers items faster. That's all it does. So realistically, just gather them as soon as you can. That way you're not sitting at max, just to be on the safe side, because there is some good items in there that you can get sometimes, depending on what you're going to get. It varies from person to person. And it's just pure luck. I shouldn't say person to person, but it varies from every gather. It's luck. It's very luck based. It's similar to like how you get items from chocobos. It's in that sense. But you'll get all kinds of stuff. And there is going to be a exchange shop as usual. It looks like we're getting a gingerbread / candy house or something of Hell House. So that's kind of interesting. It's pretty neat. Especially if you're a type of person who likes to make those things. And then luxurious rewards. This is basically just going to be a free event weapon. It looks like it's going to be Tifa. So this is going to probably make a lot of people sad, because generally speaking, so far anyway, if there is an event weapon that's free, there is no costume for that character. And I'm sure a lot of people were hoping for some kind of lingerie Tifa or something like that. A lot of people probably wanted that, but that's likely not happening. Instead, we are getting somebody else for this. a bit of a shocker. I guess not a shocker because it's been data mined for a while, but a shocker in the sense of it's like, it's a little creepy, I guess. This is just my personal view on it. When it comes to kids and the way people dress them up, I find it a little bit creepy. I get that it's a Japanese culture thing, but it doesn't mean that it's still not creepy. But I'll show you guys the video here that was posted that kind of shows it for you here. So here you go. And so there's going to be like the whole event thing that you got to have here. It's going to have its own little story thing. So it looks like it may add even maybe a side story. There's the Hell House. Kind of cool, right? Pretty sweet looking. And there it is. That is going to be the new... That is... let me get back to that. That is going to be the new banner costume right there. It looks like it's going to be the Maid Yuffie. Now, that was kind of data mined, man, way back, I think, when this game first came out. So to finally see it, it's like, whoa, it does exist. So that's kind of the thing I was saying. That's kind of cringe because she's 16 years old. So it's a, personally for me, I don't know, someone that's 16 years old, the last thing I want to see them is in a maid outfit, especially because it's heavily sexualized in Japan. And if you do that here in the US, yeah, that ain't going to go over so well. But yeah, so that's going to be the new banner. I probably won't pull on it just because, like I said, it kind of creeps me out a little bit. So that's likely going to be a no from me. But hey, that's cool, right? Because I think what I'm going to start doing now is I'm going to start hoarding my crystals until I get to like limited banners, because I think limited banners are probably going to give me the most value and I can get everything else that I more or less need in the game at this point after spending some on just through all my tickets and everything. And as of right now, I have nearly 500 tickets saved up. Once this new event hits, I'm probably going to have 500 more tickets. We're probably going to get some tickets from the co-op that's going to have the Efreet and everything like that. But that's pretty much everything that's coming in here. That's happening on Tuesday, 6 p.m. So if you guys are going to check it out, I'll be streaming that live so you guys can see me do the event and everything. And I voice act all the stuff. So any stories, you'll get some voice acting out of me from it. That's just what I do. And then we'll go over the co-op battles and things like that. I'll take them on. If you guys want to join me in doing some of the fights, fantastic. You know, if you need help with them, I can join in, help you carry you guys, whatever it may be. But that pretty much covers all some of the news that came out today. Surprisingly, it's coming out Tuesday instead of Thursday. A little bit interesting. They normally do everything Thursday. But if you guys, and the pretty much last thing, if you guys haven't finished up your Golden Bomb Rush, if you haven't gotten all of the memories from here, make sure you go ahead and try to get those filled out. This is my alternate account. My main account, I'm actually forming it as I'm speaking to you guys right now on a separate screen. I can even show it to you here, in fact. I'm trying to get the rest of the stuff because I'm really, really close. There's my main account doing it. It's doing its thing right now. But I'm really, really close to getting all of them, and I have only about maybe 1,500 gold coins left or something like that. So as soon as those get done, I'm going to head back over to the Sephiroth thing and grind the crap out of that to get all as many gold tickets as I can, because those are just too valuable. Usually these card events like we just had with Christmas, which is coming back for this Valentine's Day one, usually you don't need to do a ton of grinding in those that I remember, because the currency they use isn't stamina, so you don't have to worry about stamina in it. You're going to get those cards, and those are going to be what you're going to use to do the event. So you don't really need to worry about stamina. So if you have, so don't feel like you have to save your stamina. Go ahead and blow it, because this event coming up is not going to use that. So that's going to be a great thing for you guys. You don't have to worry about it. But yeah, so we'll see you guys on Tuesday. We'll have some more events. I'll have another video or two come out tomorrow, and I'll catch you guys next time. Peace! Thank you for watching the video. If you guys enjoyed it, make sure to hit like and subscribe. You can catch me live every single day on Twitch and YouTube. So be sure to check the links down below in the description for my channels. And I will see you guys on the next video.